Welcome everyone to another exciting episode of Q Sports. My name is Emmanuel Odufejo, and as usual, I have in the studio with me, Sir Joachim Idada.
My pleasure.
Always glad to have you in the studio.
Sure. So it's nice talking what I call Q Sports.
Yeah.
Every sport that happens in the bar. I love talking about it.
Every sport that happens in the bar. That's so snooker, billiards, pool, and what else?
Darts.
Darts also.
You know, bowling. You like bowling?
Bowling.
Yeah.
Nice. Mm-hmm. I thought that's only done in the Aggie or something like that.
Yeah, something like that.
Okay.
But there's always a bar.
All right. We'll be analyzing, talking about, you know, focus on infrastructure as we did last week. We'll still continue, and then we'll shed more light on the bar as the place for Q-Sports,
yes.
In general,
yeah.
What role does these bars play,
yeah,
you know, in the development of Q-Sports in general?
Sure.
Fantastic. Stay tuned for that. Would also be, of course, our facts file will fly across your screen. It's a good time to learn one thing or two. And also our quiz for the week would also fly across your screen. It's not, as usual we say, it's not
a competition.
It's not a competition, you know, but you get to learn one or two things about the beautiful game of the Q Sports. All right, our guest of the week, as usual, is going to be Wally Oshoma.
Sure.
80s, 90s?
Yeah, some of those who played pool in and snooker in the 80s, 90s, you know, he was one of the most dreaded players that we had.
Fantastic, you'll get to see him on this episode of Q Sports. And of course, we'll close with our match of the week, the 2012 Welsh Open, talking about Max Selby versus Steve Maguire.
Yeah.
How was that?
These are professional players. When they play, they enjoy it. You see the beauty of any sports. When professionals tip to the board in any sport, you enjoy the beauty.
Alright, I'm going to leave you to make your decisions about how beautiful was the 2012 Welsh Open. Alright, just before we jump right straight into it, remember that you can always connect with us on all of our social media handles, whether on Instagram, Facebook and Twitter. And of course, you can also watch previous episodes of Q Sports on YouTube, SNTV TV. Fantastic. You'll see all of our social media handles flying across your screen. Please follow us, join the conversation, and we would always like to hear from you. Stay tuned, we'll be back after this break. Back everybody, this is still Q Sports. My name is Emmanuel Odufejo. Alright, let's jump right straight into it. So, talking development of Q Sports, what role does all of these bars where we have snooker being played, pool or billiards, what role do these bars have to play in the development of our beloved sport?
Globally, all over the world, the bar is a natural home of all cue games or cue sports or billiards sports. Billiards is like there's a game called billiards, but globally, all of those cue sports are normally referred to as billiard sports. Mm-hmm. And the bar is the natural home. So, what the field is to football, mm-hmm. Wherever there's a space, you can easily play football. So, ordinarily, wherever there's a bar, it should be assumed that you should have access to some of these cue sports. One of the challenges you have all over the world, also, you could see that most the owners of the bars, they normally use these cue sports as the vehicle of improving, or they invest in cue sports as a way of improving the recreational value in their various bars. So, and that is why you have what you call a sports bar and a bar. There's a difference between a sports bar and a bar. Normally, a bar is classified just as a place where you can drink. But when it comes to a sports bar, it goes much higher. Not only a place where you can drink, it's now a place where you can actually recreate and entertain yourself. You can sit down, you can spend hours and hours on end enjoying yourself. You're either playing pool, you're playing snooker, and you're getting involved in billiards, or you're getting involved in other bar-based sports. So the bar is the nucleus of all of the sports. Where the bar does not show, where those who own bars or those who own bars, where they don't show any interest, they'll say, oh, we are only interested in providing young people to just come and drink one or two bottles of beer, drink pepper soup. We are not taking pepper soup, we are taking shiver. Another beautiful thing about it is because when you drink, you go and eat pepper soup and all of that, somehow all of this food gets stored in your body. You don't really need to go 1,000 kilometers away to go and burn it and lose all of it, all the fat and all we have accumulated. With these cue sports, the benefit is that even as you're drinking and you're playing it, you tend to exercise. Even as you're eating ACU and you're doing that, you tend to exercise. So not only does these cue sports add entertainment to recreational value, it also offers some health benefits. To people that come to the bar.
Fantastic. All right, we'll be back after this break. Don't go anywhere. Welcome back, everyone. We're still talking infrastructure, the role that bars play in the development of cue sports. And you were talking about how bars have been able to add the natural home of cue sports in general.
Yes, the bars have been the natural home. One of the greatest challenges we have here in Nigeria is I don't know whether it's lack of knowledge or understanding, but I remember that after the First World War, when there was recession, especially in the United Kingdom. One way that the brewery industry used to encourage people to go back, because there's recession, no money to live, but one way the brewery industry used to go back and to promote the business, that's the whole drink business, or the bar business, or what we call that, or the pub business, was that they encourage what we call inter-bar competitions. Mm. occurring tobacco conditions. But if you come to Nigeria, we are not seeing that kind of move where we have a network of bars who share the same value coming together to interact and to compete one with another. It's very ridiculous if bar A and bar B say want to do drinking competition or want to do it perversity competition, then let us see which bar can bring in people that can eat the most pepper soup. But when you go to Europe, when you go to America, when you go to the Netherlands, Australia, if you go to Asia most especially, you see there are a lot of interbar activities that go on, where you have things like interbar leagues for snooker, interbar leagues for pool, interbar leagues for other games. So in Nigeria, I think those are some of the things that are missing in our architecture, our developmental architecture, especially when it comes to some of these sports we are talking about. So I think one of the critical things we need to do is how to educate owners of bars. And part of that is the brewing industry, I believe they are not playing that critical role. Because if the brewing industry invests in educating people as much as they are giving I hear one of the support they give them, oh, we can give you memorabilia, we can give you gifts in case you are doing activation and all of that kind of thing. If they do seminars where people can come and educate the owners of bars on marketing strategy, how to improve sales, how to improve customer patronage, how to improve spend, how to improve the periods that people spend in the bar. A classical example is that when I was living once in Idim. When I was living in Idim, it was not as bad as coming from Lagos to Idim was. Highest you spend is 45 minutes. But by the time I moved from Idim, I moved to Ogba, it took like 2.5 hours. Now, if you are going from Lekki to Azumi, you are going from Lekki to Yanashashi, you are going from Lekki to Akuti. Some people will leave 4 o'clock and they are getting there 9 o'clock. It makes no sense for me that you spend 5 hours of your day
commuting.
In the morning, you do 5 hours or 4 hours in the morning, in the evening when you close from work. In the morning, you are doing close to two, three hours. And so people have to leave home as early as 4 o'clock, 4:30, just so that they can meet their 8 o'clock resumption time. So the question, one of the issues I say is that when you close from work at 5 o'clock, one of the ways you can spend your time, instead of burning all your whole time, you burn your fuel, put yourself under stress, and it is when you close at 5 o'clock, around your office, for a place where you can recreate. If the bar has recreational amenities where the individual does not need to go and pay millions and millions just because they want to go and join an exclusive club, your style. But there's a bar close by you like you have where you can from your office, you can easily walk to 5 minutes, 10 minutes, you are there. And you spend your good time there. And at the end of the day, if you do that, you spend 4 hours there, 5 hours, even if you spend 5 hours there, and you leave there at 12 o'clock, it helps you because at the end of the day, you are
not stressed,
you are relaxed, you are regretted, you feel good. And so at that point in time, you can now go home and say you want to go and rest and sleep. And with that time, if you are going home at 10, in 30 minutes, in 45 minutes, you traverse the whole of Port Miller Bridge, coming from Lekki all the way to Ojojo or wherever you are living. So you can see the benefit. But because the bars are not playing that role, they are not investing in the recreational aspect of their business. You see, everybody, you close from work, everybody is doing.
Fantastic. I think the idea is that bars need to recognize, you know, that they are a critical part, you know,
yeah,
developing Q sports and that challenge of you know, ensuring that you know each bar has, you know, maybe a snooker table, a pool
table, have recreational amenities,
something, recreational amenities in general, so that people can, you know, that's one reason why you can go to bars. Aside from eating and drinking, you can also participate in other recreational amenities, which can, you know, give you some health benefits as well as a good, way to relieve stress.
Yes,
right. Yeah. Fantastic. All right. So that's the long and short of our whole conversation around, you know, infrastructure, using bar as a critical example.
Yes, using bar, because if we get the bars involved,
right? Yeah.
I can assure you, in no time, we'll be as good as, because right now in Africa, it's Egypt and South Africa, or the Southern Africa, not South Africa, as Egypt and Southern Africa, that is leading in some of these activities. Never, we call ourselves giants of Africa.
Fantastic. It's been exciting talking Q-Sports, focusing our satellite on the development of how bars really help in the development of Q-Sports. All right, moving forward, we'll be looking at our player's profile, the exciting, the beautiful, and the talented Janet Lee. She will be our player's profile for this week. And then we would flash on our screen facts file and also our quiz for the week. Please participate as much as you can. When we come back, you would get to meet our guest of the week, Wale Oshomo is his name. He stopped by at the studio during the week, and Joaquim Idada had the pleasure of interviewing him. Stick around and enjoy this interview.